I mean, I guess Luna can still fight because you have Eclipse and you have a lot of damage that you add to the team.
Your lanes are really strong with that.
I feel why it's really strong here. He can make Axe Illusion to pretty much just farm jungle or push out any lane. And you have a save against a Chrono if you really need one.
So I guess it's going to be the Ogre with the Axe lane if they want to pressure. Ogre, Axe, and SD with the safe lane. If Elder Titan is roaming, they might be able to pressure that safe lane a lot. So this game crit on the Elder Titan probably has to focus more on the safe lane. It's if it's up against the Axe plus Ogre dual lane.
We could see something like a Luna from MVP, but against Elder Titan is really risky because you don't want to be going AC. You usually just go like agility. So picking something like a Luna is really pretty hard, I think. Probably focus more on something like a Mirana. Their usual aggressive style.
If OG don't consider snagging it for themselves, we'll have to see. Third pick, or maybe the safer bet is grabbing up something for Fly in the meantime, not revealing
Cuttle,
I think your hand.
Cuttle might be good here, because SD Ogre sort of suggests that they might go for illusion-based carry. So having the Cuttle that is really good for them.
Nice combo, man. Keeper is going to be the pick. The third one here for OG. And then immediate response from MVP, they go right back for the PA.
They do this in the first game. They see a squishy support or two heroes that you can very easily jump on the backline, and they just pick up the PA.
Why Ghost Scepter?
Yeah, but is Fly actually going to get enough farm? Because, I mean, yeah, you can stack the jungle and whatnot, but I think the lane's going to actually be so pressured you might not have time in the early game to be able to get your own item.
I guess that's a fair point. Like, if the game doesn't go well, you rarely see the keeper get a Ghost Scepter like way too early.
This game, they actually have a lot of saves for the support in the back. Like, Titan can stomp him pretty easily, and Void can time dilation him, then he can't jump and blink anymore. You will need a BKB for that.
Yep, Blinding Light too, which will help a little bit for his base PA. And very good against PA. OG gets Spent.
I'm for the Spent.
Very good pick here. Yep. The armor is really good versus the PA general. So PA's damage output in teamfights would be severely limited by this pick here.
Yeah, it's a good pick. And you can have like double armor up as well if you get Chakra Magic before. And then you have like a duration of 12 seconds where you're practically immune to damage.
Yeah, sure. Sure that you pick the hero for that.
Why not?
5 seconds remaining.
I would much rather have Timber for that mana.
Yeah, but they banned it.
OG's or maybe a Conker, double Type Ringer.
Oh, double Type Ringer is so sick with Echo Saber.
Yeah, lately though, unfortunately, we've been seeing more of that support Conker, and we can't see his true potential unleashed with Cuddle. I agree. Last bans though coming out, and
do MVP play Dusa?
They did occasionally on QO, but pretty much only QO. Like he plays both the heroes.
Because they have PA, they won't play it.
MP is usually more the guy that suffers and doesn't get that much farm. Yeah. Runs around the map and tries to make things happen.
Reserve like for OG, like Invoker could still fit up into their heroes. And it's still a very good pick for them.
10 seconds remaining.
Fumble, they have the Stomp from Elder Titan and there's Chrono Sphere. Yeah. There's three spells to set up the Invoker here.
They do have to be really careful though. PA lanes really well against the Invoker, and if an Ogre just roams in, you're actually just dead. It's really hard to help you.
You would rather have a hero that's harder to gank in the mid lane.
What would you guys say if they ran it out instead with something like a classic Storm Spirit to match up there? It's typically a good partner with the Carl. Do you think he would be okay in that matchup?
I think you actually get harassed a ton. Storm versus PA. You just eat daggers all day, and even if you have high base armor, it's still kind of a struggle for a lot of these heroes.
You do have the chakra for the Storm though.
Yeah, that's actually true as well.
Tinker, of course.
This is much better because they have a lot of global presence with the Cuttle, plus the Recall, and you have Boots of Travel, and you have the Spirit to TP onto.
I'm a bit worried for MVP. They already don't have the greatest high ground push, and against that lineup, you can pretty much never breach it. Like,
they have to win their lanes. If they don't win their lanes, I don't think they can do this game.
They have to win their lanes for sure, and they have no Tinker counter at all.
I feel this might, like so far, be the biggest outdraft of the series by OG.
Unless there's that one magical pick, gentlemen, that could pull it all together here for MVP. The good anti-tinker, something good to be able to accelerate the laning phase and take control so OG can't take it back.
Anti-tinker is like Storm or Spectre. I'm not sure if those heroes are good here against Tinker.
Anti-mage is pretty good too, but he's really bad against Sven. Or they go for them Invoker themselves.
MVP
might be a cross-vex Invoker. Like MP plays a cross-vex Invoker.
All right, Andy, I ask you first here. You said it's a bit of an outdraft. Do you think the Invoker still...
I don't think it's enough. I think OG still have a pretty big advantage.
Alright. I actually think Invoker gets outlaned by Tinker as well, so I will go for OG this game as well.
Yeah, I don't think that Invoker actually salvage what MVP have right now, so I'm gonna go for OG.
Alright, all my panel thinks it's gonna be OG. We'll see if the casters agree. Why don't we go ahead and throw it over to them right now? We got Toby Wan and Merlini out on the floor. Gentlemen, take it away.
It's a good question, Merlini. Do you agree?
I don't know, 5-0 on PA, they just
know something special about the hero and play really well around it. I don't think you can discount that.
Yep, so you just need to catch out, right? You just need to find the Tinker. If we go with the Quaswex Invoker, maybe a long-range Tornado, can find him in the tree line. Some good warding, some good laning.
It's a lot of good stuff. It's nothing reliable, like Spectre pressed R. Oh, there's Spectre.
Oh, there he is. Or Storm Spirit's got the mana. He can chase him wherever he goes. Mm-hmm. Yeah, this doesn't exist for them. So MVP will have a tough run, just judging off the draft. But if anyone can do it, MVP have proven they can be the one. So into the game we go as MVP and OG start up game number 3 of this winner's bracket quarterfinal at the International 2016.
I think even more problematic than the Tinker is giving OG the Elder Titan. It's almost always first ban against crit. He was one of the first players to bring it into what we currently know as competitive Dota in the most recent iteration, and like it's such a nuisance playing against it.
It's so quick as well for that mid lane. MVP is going to get lucky. They put down a sentry ward, and they're going to find a very aggressive observer ward that OG has already planted down. So, small advantage. Invoker gets to get the first CS on the board. Small advantage.
Yeah, it looks to be a Quaswex, though. Quaswex is pretty good. It's a lot of what they needed. Decent control, and
if you can control long enough for QO to do the damage, then it all works out.
Mm-hmm. He has a tough job though. He can't do everything. He needs to you need someone to jump the keeper. You need someone to interrupt the Elder Titan combo, stop the Void from doing his thing, and then kite the Sven. And then after that, you can deal with the Tinker.
It's funny, if you're looking for a way to checklist that off, you've got that. You've got ST Disruption to really interfere with the Void. You've got Ogre, Lockdown, Axe, Jump in with Blink Daggers. All these things can work. Moon, okay, Moon. Is there going to be a stun? There's a Fireball, and well, the Burn, Moon. Time walks off a lot of the damage, but he's still got 2 poison levels on him. He's probably not going to survive this. No way to time walk out. And Burst Blood will go the way of MVP as Moon gets very greedy, chasing the Bounty Room.
He had it down there very, very early. I think SD is one of the better supports to deal with the Faceless Void. You can't time walk off the Shadow Poison stacks. So I think it's going to continue to be a struggle for him. But no signs of a Quelling Blade yet. Moon does start with a Magic Stick and returns to lane immediately.
I love how Febby starts his mid lane. It's like, okay, well, Miracle's going to get up in the face of MP. How do we change the trade-off? Let's just bring... Basically, we've got the Gambler Man, Ogre Majai, up against Foambolt Crit. And they have to force him out. 2 insanely tanky heroes. Maybe Febby a little bit more tankier than the other Titan just because of his high armor. And he's just trying to zone it all out. It's just split the lane at the end of the day, though.
He has to be careful once the Invoker gets some levels because he can actually catch the Elder Titan if he's far away from lane. Is a lot of reach. Looking for No-Tail, wonder what build he's going to go this game. We've seen HOD a lot, but sometimes we see the armlet fighting build earlier, which might be necessary. I think the armor is very important versus a Phantom Assassin, even though he has Warcry.
Be a better lane as well, even if PA is going to... Okay, well, maybe that's not great for him when he has to time walk off just a Stifling Dagger. Chris pushing him out.
Even Keeper light a lot on bottom. He's taking out double stack right now.
Levels on Keeper of the Life, but not just that. Able to get... If he can actually get enough money on him, getting an early Aghanim's. OG's going to have a lot of items to fight with, split push with, even harder, more than the Tinker is already going to do.
Tower is under attack.
Maybe he's really just itching for a go here at Tinker. Hey, they got Cold Snap and Tornado available, so it's going to force Miracle back underneath his own tier 1. Tinker still also crit has to hang at this mid lane.
Miracle's at that critical point too. He doesn't quite have his bottle yet. Still needs one more team. Is he going to bring out a salve? Is it a bottle or what?
Selfish.
Not sure.
Find out in a bit. The MP and Febby, again, they still... Miracle's low and you got to be cautious about this. I'm also keeping my eyes on Ferev. Ferev almost died to an Alpha Wolf stack, but he's still... pushing the envelope a little bit inside the jungle. Managed to find 18 CS already, 4.5 levels. Not too bad when you compare him to his counterpart in OG, which is Moon. 2.5 levels and found 0 CS. He just can't get anything out of that lane apart from presence.
Well, and they actually had crit TP mid to bring the bottle for Miracle, so he'll get a few extra free charges from Elder Titan. They'll kind of salvage that and make things easy. I think Keeper's just one of those heroes that you don't want to really leave alone. He just farms the jungle so efficiently.
Abby trying to TP as quickly as he possibly could to get back to MP. Miracle initiated with high level up in laser and rocket. No points up a march of machines. Miracle's gone for a big combat build. He wants to help out. Still with tornado available. Crits on the front lines. Pulse snap will cool down in 1 second time. Not going to find that opening there. Or will they? Stuns on Miracle. He's getting back to that T1 tower. The extra stun, but crit too quickly. The Echo's gone. Now with MP, US turn around. The rockets from Miracle. They find the kill. He's got enough mana for one more laser, but the more damage needs to be done to Febby before he can find the kill. Now TP in the mid lane. This Zubu, disruption, but the spirit's out. No stop to go with it. Zubu is trying to solo kill on Miracle with a poison. He may still have enough. Zubu low, and he will drop. SD will find it, but Miracle with a double kill.
Perfect timing from the stomp on Elder Titan. They were waiting for the Fire Blast to set up for the tornado, so they would guarantee that I wouldn't miss. But too good by Elder Titan. Right place, right time.
That wasn't even where MVP really wanted to fight. They had three players preparing themselves to fight in the top lane, trying to get that pick off on Moon. They're still trying to buy more space. Ferev farming very, very quickly inside the jungle. I'll have to do something about him soon.
Dire's Tranquil's tower
Iron Talon still progressing nicely.
I think they're getting enough out of lanes. Not really under too much pressure. OG maybe start looking to stack some for Tinker. Crit comes in for another bottle refill. Giving him a lot of help.
It's Miracle efficiently in the mid lane. That's what it's all about. Bottom lane, Febby. He's got Notel. Notel try to initiate onto that Ogre, but now Ferev, he comes off out of the jungle. The Illumina's gonna hit pretty hard, meaning Febby can't really keep up with this. But Ferev, he just needs some spins, but he can't get any. So Notel runs out the sound, healing him up. With a couple of spins there, Ferev would have had an opportunity to Culling Blade down Notel.
Yeah, he's level 7.
That's that farming axe.
And Joker almost dies in mid lane. Level 3 laser and level 2 missile. As you mentioned, the combat build earlier.
Crit's looking for it. He's thinking, and I think MP also knows what's going on. He's hovering around MP in the mid lane with a smoke maneuver. Axe has to loop him behind, or you can just use disruption into initiation. MP lands the call snap and Miracle. The extra health for Ev gets the dunk. And Crit spends all of his time wandering around trying to find that pick on MP, but never finding his target, never found the Invoker.
I like how active Forev is. As soon as he hits level 7, boom. I gave too much time to the Keeper, too much space to the Tinker, and he's gonna start moving around. And he has great sustain too, Tranquil and Infused Raindrops to make sure that he's always fight and combat ready. And Moon's also nearing critical HP on top.
And he's gotta be careful once Qro hits level 6, then all of a sudden you could have a surprise dagger damage. He's a lot more cautious on this offlane.
This could be a very early blink from this.
Taking one more stack at the minute. Taking out the stacks, finding the kills. Also gonna be a slow BT from Miracle. For all the help the crew's been trying to give him, Miracle, that like Tinker has still only got 22 CS in this mid lane. Like both mids haven't got that much CS. But it's more important for the Tinker with his progression into BTs to have that global influence. Invoker can still go hand of minus and play catch up later on.
However, Fly's free farming on bottom, and he's almost level 6 on the Keeper, while still giving almost full lane experience to the Sven. So, we haven't seen too much active from OG's bottom lane, but sooner or later, it'll start to pay off for them.
Oh, bottom lane, Notel wants to have a crack. He's gone for the war cry into a storm bolt. Maybe dropping low, the Illumina damage isn't enough to find the kill. It is a higher level than normal, so a level 2. That's a very tanky Yoga. And Yoga's almost level 6 as well.
Gonna get some roll.
The Ferret's going again. So again, they go for this disruption into a walk-in call. And, well, Notel is so far up with the creep wave there. Start with the Battle Hunger. Ferev to fall him into the tree line. Dubu gonna see Fly. They let the poison go to start with. Dubu, does he want to disrupt that right now? He's looking for it. The call will hold North. Notel in position. Baby's helping out from the tree line. The Stormwall server on Dubu. So Notel with the Illuminate. Oh, it's just off target. But Dubu's dying. There's a creep wave. He'll fall down with a Culling Blaze there from Ferev. So bonus movement speed. He still needs more help. And it's on the way. Invoker MP through the tree line. Gets that tornado on the crit. He wants to go for the stomp, but Ferev finds this another dunk. Two heroes lost for OG, even if MVP do lose their SD to the creep wave under the tier 1.
for Evan, Shadow Demon moving around very well around the map. Just isolating the Sven. Sven has HUD, has not yet dominated a creep, but I think OG need to work on their stacking game very soon. MVP already prepped up. Observer Ward on the high ground, and the Observer Ward close to the Tinker stacks too. Miracle in a precarious position right now, 650 gold away from the BOTs. But Blink Dagger on Axe is coming, and just 200 gold. He'll have it after this game. I think they might be able to hit the smoke blink timing before his BOTs.
That's so dangerous once Axe actually has that. And not relying on the SD. He didn't rely on the SD in that last fight, primarily because Ven was just so deep. And then Notel switches his lanes. Goes up to the top lane, dominates one of the range creeps, now starts to attack. It's all going to be all about the flash farm, but MVP have an observe ward watching most of that happening. Mid lane, Chronosphere, Moon goes on MP, Miracle with a laser and the rocket underneath the Marsh Machine, Zubu, defensive disruption, keeps him up now, no top content, Kuro TP's from the Monica, MP's at movement speed, and he gets away, he's actually Envis, away from the Sentry Wand, oh, Barab, he actually manages to grab the two of them, Zubu will get the kills with the high levels up in poison, they want to go for more, they split away from the Stomp, Zubu the only affected one, Kuro no stifling daggers, they don't have the slope of Barab, another jump in, he called Miracle, Kuro goes in with him, with the crit, and the Axe Culling Blade, once again they get the Modus movement speed, looking for the kills. They'll run away MVP, they've done the damage, they're pretty low. No reason to risk anything more. It just, that's the second time MP's been escaping on so low life, but still involved in the fight. Should be careful, however. He doesn't need all the orbs and sentries, but maybe not. He thought he had something there, but, well, he thought only R3 dies.
Very quick from MVP to TP in there, just in time with the SD save, and Notel getting a little greedy too. He didn't actually storm bolt the Invoker, just assuming that he was dead, and goes for the Storm Hammer onto Kuo, and MVP just gets saved with the under the guise of the Ghost Walk, and after that, Forev catches him out with his Blink Dagger. That's not really a timing that you expect. 9 minutes, Tranquil Blink.
Gonna get worse for him too, with Forev getting involved in all these kills. He's now sitting on 1,000 gold, so if he starts getting tankier, OG may not have the damage to deal with it. Notel still a way away from getting that Echo Saber up and running. You still are lacking Miracle's BTs.
And very different build from Kuo this game. He doesn't wait out for the Dezo, instead going for the Vladimir's Offering. Curious choice. I guess they don't have the Void to build a platform this game, and they want much more Roshan potential because they don't have an Exhort Invoker available to them this time. And Quas Wex Invoker is just not good at taking out Rosh.
Like Kuo have sustained directly on him when he wants to move through the jungles. But MVP, a nice start for them so far. They hold the advantage, about 5k in the experience, just over 4,000 in the gold. And they're going to push this even further with Kuo slipping into the pit for a quick and easy Roshan. That's what the early Vlad is allowing you to do as well. But OG, they have to try and stop this. You have an Elder Titan, fantastic, at slowing down Roshan.
Notel has different plans though. Looks like he's gonna pop his God Strength and start to work at his Ancients, and he's gonna be nowhere close to that fight.
So this is OG just saying, we are not even ready to fight.
I don't know if they expected this early, because we didn't see this build from Phantom Zest. I don't think they expected it with a Crossbow Invoker and no lifesteal of any sort. And you'll see the Elder Titan Spear go to the pit right now, and Stomp comes out, Kuo gets stunned out, and OG, they can head over there, but
it's too late, they don't have the numbers for it.
I think although it is the POT, the one Tinker.
They get an intent, instead of trying to go for a little bit of a trade-off, Moon pushes the creep wave up, and this is why the ET was hesitant to come over. That Axe Blink Dagger, easy jump. And yet again, another kill.
Or F seems much more comfortable on Axe. This game.
Top tower most definitely. Attack. This is a lot more comfortable game for everyone on MVP. Good aggression, early movements, even MP's having himself a good game on this Invoker.
Axe is a big problem for them. Like, he can jump anyone at this point, even the tanky Sven, and he might be in danger of dying. And they've slowed down the Tinker Radiant's so much with those two Carls and the Coles.
The fact you... Okay, at attack. Least Miracle has BTs up and running. And this is the other big upside of OG's lineup. They're really, really good at high ground defense, so MVP need to be a long way ahead. They don't have the advantage of something like a Batrider, get a Blink initiation, drag back out, kill nice attack. And quick. So instead, they're going to rely on the pure strength of their lineup.
might be time for MD to start thinking about transitioning, though. You can see him pick up a Glove of Haste and realizing that, okay, OG, they're going to play the longer game. They have the Keeper for the recall, so even the Spend can slip push. They have a Tinker for the high ground hold, so they're not going to be able to
need to play catch up anyway. This is a nice pick. Fly, Rev, Blink, okay. Bolt Tornado, not great as the in the world. But it won't matter. For Rev, already a level 2 Cunning Blade. And that Keeper of the Light didn't stand a chance. And they're even going to find Sven's double stack. Rev can take that fairly easily.
And OG trying to trade off their own jungle for Dire's jungle. They've started warring it up, and Moon and the rest of OG will start farming it. But I don't know, with this Mian T1 tower under heavy siege and no Keeper there to defend them.
I think QR wants to go on bot lane. Miracle, Stifling Dagger, where's your crit? QR hoping for it, and Miracle, he's gonna go down. Waited for Laser to be used for farming, now Moon arrives, QO in too deep. Miracle can't rearm in time to Chrono! You can surround Miracle! The A is the one will trigger. Miracle will pop him with the EMP from MT that did the work off for Rev. Gets the call, gets the control on Nurtel. Ghost Rage being triggered, whilst Warcry's, he's got some survivability, and QO wants to run away. He'll have to run back in again, or maybe he can just blink himself over, killing off Fly. The Tornado taking Sven out of the pitcher. He wants for Rev, but the Cutting Blade again! They go through them all! MVP! It is a slaughter! OG on the bot lane can't do anything. QO in again! Keep the stuns, keep the control, and keep the chase going. Moon Time Walker's up in 2 seconds time, but does he have it? 1 second, back to the tier 3 tower. QO, he's going in deep. This isn't your home, QO, but he won't carry one of the crit. Now, he'll jump away and let Moon survive.
What? Who told him to bet?
I don't know. Middle
tower is under attack. I totally expect him to go from there, but, you know, respawns are coming.
But they also are here for objective-based gaming. Do some damage to that tier 2 tower. Difficult when the spirit is up.
That whole fight started off bottom because the Tinker didn't have laser up. He actually used it on a creep. It is good for efficiency, but it's bad if a right clicker is going to jump on top of you. QO almost falls to a lot of
This is what we're talking about with OG.
But look at Nodel. Nodel also has no mana. He has to get chakra'd at the moment because of the EMP. So now, slowly transitioning out, MP uses his first Midas on a large centaur.
Look at that Groff just swing down to MVP. Such a huge advantage. And here is that moment again. QO, just hope for one more crit. Moon, a big saving grace for Miracle. The problem was, with the support rotating down, there was no way Miracle was going to survive. That EMP was perfect target. And you commit the Chronosphere, and all you burn is the EMP board. Now they go again, we come back live for Rev, holding Nurtel. All Nurtel wants is to farm, and he will be denied that as another chunk for Rev. Racking up so many kills, 8-0-2 now on this Axe.
MVP is just strangling OG, and every time they try to venture out to farm somewhere that's beyond their T2, they are just stifled immediately. And they have, like, okay vision, but the problem is they can't really fight at the moment. Tinker doesn't have Blink Dagger, he can't reposition himself like in the Chronosphere or around the Chronosphere to get multiple marches off. And Sven doesn't have a Blink Dagger, so he's still very vulnerable if he gets jumped.
Radiant's middle tower. So MVP moving the first tier 2 tower, so open up the mid, but it's only 16 minutes in. They're still going to look to bring down more outer towers before they think about attacking OG's racks.
Need to play it patient, and luckily for them today, he's already kind of set that plan in motion by taking down the first Roche very early on. So you're going to talk about breaking base with like Aegis number 2, Aegis number 3, and that timeline's going to be sooner than most.
A lot of items on them as well at that point. Looking at a buckler now over on Febby. I was wondering who was actually going to be the mech builder in this game. It looks to be him with Shadow Demon, a casual ring, so we'll probably consider Lotus Orb.
Maybe just standard Aether.
That'll be fine.
I don't even know if they need a mech. I think, I don't know. Maybe a pipe later to deal with Tinker. I think it's going to be especially problematic because if you ET and Tinker, it's just a nightmare. You're going to have to get PK.
Nurtail once again. All he wants to do is farm. And he's going to be denied all of his mana. The Blinding Light will force Dyer's him back out. Mano holding Nurtail in position. The Poison and the Purge is just stacking up so heavily. The Dooboos, he has done some serious lifting this game.
Yeah, I like the way he's been playing this game. Very active around the map. When they have kill opportunities later, the supports can shine on MVP. When they have kill, just farming it doesn't really seem like they know what to do. They're just so used to it.
This Axe hunting for another kill with a fresh Blade Mail. Go with that early Vanguard. 18-minute Axe who is almost beating PA for net worth. Just for the opening to MVP, they are looking to go high ground now.
Still, a good Chronosphere could turn this around. They have a lot of damage to dump in the Chronosphere, even if the Sven is in the grave. And now with the Blink Dagger on Tinker, might be able to dodge and make some more fancy moves.
Smart from Fly to already get that Sentry Ward down inside the base. He cannot let OG, MVP have vision inside their base. That gives an opportunity for Axe to choose a right place to go. A Miracle is adding pressure to the top lane, not an upside about Blade Mail. That's made Tinker a lot more scared of him. Selfish.
QO is much more farmed than he was in game number one. I think he picked up Dezo around 20-something this game. He has Dezo on top of Vlad's and 1500 gold. And...
Four-man smoke, Tinker moves forward. He's looking for the PA. Rocket in the last two. Warcry's been triggered to give the extra movement speed here to OG, but MVP, they're coming over and they're hoping OG, that MVP will try and contest the Ancients, walking out to the high ground blindly.
You need BKBs to do that, to take a straight on fight where they can't jump them without vision. Radiant has you scan, making sure that I guess no one's at a secret shop.
Now that MVP could have been smoking to try and flank them.
Mm-hmm. I think they'd be okay with that though, because they had that ward on the high ground, and Void kind of thrives in those sort of situations. And MVP does not look like they're going to be able to get the T1. Have fun dealing with Marge.
Well, they're already backed out. They're actually denying OG every fight that OG want to take. OG are definitely grouped up. They are ready to try and have a 5-on-5. Chrono, Splinter, Illuminate, all this. They just want to throw it at MVP.
I wonder what Febby's going for. Okay, he's going for mech instead of pipe. I was considering maybe pipe, but he can also just get both. But OG finally can farm these two camps safely, at least. Very important for their melee cores.
They should still be prepared for Roshan. He's up in about 1 minute.
It's a long shot for OG to take them, though. They've already invested all of their support items onto the left side of the map, and I don't think they have anything left for the right side.
Yeah, they got orbs and sentries everywhere there.
They really do have to set the Ancients though, because you want Sven to kind of get armor, a bunch of other items. He needs to be able to scale MKB at some point if you're with the TA. I'm surprised that we haven't seen too many teams trying to go with like a Silver Edge carrier to deal with a PA. A lot of times it's just magic damage or MKBs, but sometimes those two items come out a little bit late just because they're damaging the cores. They don't want to get MKB like second, generally. OG with another smoke, this could be their time.
Yeah, they need the opening. The Spirit's coming out just to have a look over towards Roshan. Roshan is about to spawn. Warcry, Axe trying to initiate the tornado, catching both boys as well as Elder Titan. No, only time walk from Moon, trying to bring him out to safety. Qo Cycling Dagger, he'll jump up and fall, instant crit on the Moon. He can't time walk off that damage straight away. And then the double fall for Rev. He found crit, he found no time to burn out. Crit can't help out. They dump one, the Chronosphere. It'll at least buy a little bit of space for Sven to hide in the tree line. But now with the Cycling Dagger, Qo will go in once again. ET. Crit has to buy back. He had to help his teammates out.
Without Faceless Void for this fight though, OG stands next to no chance. They have to retreat and wait for MVP to push into them, but that means they will concede another Roshan.
And what a call on EMP, the fact that OG just had nothing to fight with. Can't trigger any abilities, no stuns, no... It wasn't even enough for a Spirit.
And they just have better vision around the bottom side of the map. OG, they have to take them by surprise as soon as there's smoke pop. MVP, no. Okay, we can go now.
And this is when, like, more weight gets put on Miracle's shoulders. He's the highest net worth player over on OG. This creep skipper trying to keep MVP away from the base, looking towards the side lanes. A dangerous venture when MVP now have enough money to start buying items to catch him out. Just waiting in the wings, ready for a jump.
They need an Aether Lens up ASAP, so it also helps versus like the Shadow Demon Siege. Well, you'll see it more commonly with a Luna, Terror Blade, but you can also do it with PA. But she's melee, doesn't really do that much damage to towers.
Still waiting, he's still pushing that top lane out.
Oh, they still don't have Chrono for 40 seconds.
Yep, that's a level 1 Chronosphere, 130 second cooldown for it.
Well, they better hope that Elder Titan with level 4 Stomp can pull it out.
There's no March prep yet. Now Miracle. He'll do the first wave. The rockets for Rev. Try and jump. He was right on the money to find that spot of Tinker. But Tinker left a fraction of a second earlier. And with that early jump, Miracle now stifling. Dagger QO! He rips apart Miracle. Miracle does have buyback available, but QO almost at the base. Gets the crit on the fly. He finds a double kill inside the fountain of OG.
Did you see the Zerp reward planted on the south side? That's what won in the fight. That's what QO used to jump on top of the Tinker. And I think it was just placed right before that happened, and it completely caught Miracle off guard. That is a game-winning Zerp reward right there.
OG just trying to scramble defense. They don't want to expand the buyback of Miracle. They need to keep every cent they've got on him. They need to sculpt, they need to illuminate, they need to just slow down MVP's push. Now Moon, a three-man chrono. Time dilation as well. The ET split is going to come in 2-0. Low on life, but not low enough. He's still up. Now no tell. He can hit it, but he's going to lose his life. And all QO potentially lose his Aegis the Immortal. MVP can just keep going for more. Tinker is up again. So Miracle, back on the field. But QO also off. The Aegis the Immortal did trigger. They beat into the melee rack. The Rockets, however, is trying to force them out. And Crit, no splitter revival. He can spear it up onto the hillside. Start this up if he wants to. So the Yule set already on for it. Sets himself up for a re-entry. For a perfect hit. Notel also in way too deep. Call snapped up. He just can't fight properly. Perez doesn't have enough mana to go for another dunk, however. But then again, it's the Shadow Demon Poison bringing down this Zven. They come back in once more to the Breach MVP, looking for the melee racks. And there's only so long OG can hold the line. Rockets, March, everything you've got will stop MVP from diving to the fountain. And they can rotate into the mid lane. All five heroes still up.
What do OG have left for them?
Nice tornado into a call. Keeper of the light. No safe place to Illuminate down. That's the reason why Miracle creep skipped. He actually went for the mid lane to keep it out. So the tower attack leads all going on to MVP. QO now going to BKB, looking for a target. Moon, Perev can't get in range for a proper blink call just yet. Chrono on cooldown for 40 more seconds. MVP, okay. You thought they were backing up, but Perev wants in. He holds Moon in. Too early on the calling blade, but it won't matter with the Rockets. Miracle can get the pick up on the Invoker. A lot of money coming out from that kill. ET wants to go for more. Blitter is up, but OG still can't leave their base.
OG were just not given enough time. They did not expect MVP to be pushing high ground with the second Roshan under their belt. And they thought they had the stall tactics necessary with the Keeper and the Elder Titan just in case the early game went poorly. But it went just a little bit too poorly. Tinker way too underfarmed at this point. This should make my life. Scepter plus Aether, I think, had a chance for the next high ground defense. And Sven, I think, has been the biggest problem.
It's the sad day for a Sven when you're 0 kills and 8 deaths on a Sven. The only person to get a kill over on OG right now is either a creep wave or Miracle. Got 3 out of the 4 kills of OG. There's just nothing coming in for them, and high ground defense can only get you so far when the dice side have got such huge strength they can just keep diving in.
And BOT up on bottom lane, he's gonna go for Kurt right now. Perez just picked that up, and that's a 3 kill. And shoring up their anti-tinker defenses with BOT number one. Regeneration.
Almost an impossible ask for OG to come back from this. They have been stomped into the ground. Their hope is somehow for Rev feeds himself to see the advantage. 25,000 net worth, over 20k in the experience. And yeah, MVP, yeah. Like the only hope is the fact this 13 kill streak acts dies to like Tinker to give him his Aghanim Scepter finally or something. Miracle is like halfway between two different items, having to hold on to his buyback. It only costs 800 for him at the moment just because he doesn't have that much. So there goes your Agnes. He actually sacrifices everything. So no buyback available for the Tinker. They have to defend strong. The Raindrake's being brought down by QO. Now you jump in, Moon. Catching out two. They need the dunk for Perez. A huge call. Caught Miracle. Dark number one, Blinding Light won't stop this. Broken Time will cop the damage. Maybe no Tuck can do some damage to the back line. Catching out the Invoker. Illuminate flies in. MVP still taking a little bit of damage, but there is no Tinker. There is no Spam. There is no Tail. And on the Tier 4 Tower 2-0. This could be the game right now with a BKB charging. Jump in, slides inside.
going to pot OG, you'll take the mid racks, but OG is down for so long with zero buybacks. MVP, if they want to, they can be safe or they can go for the GG push here.
And what a crazy PI that has started off to become OG. Straight to the loser's bracket, 2-1 by MVP on the back of QO's Phantom Assassin yet again. M4M, what an incredible act performance coming out from him.
This was so good. OG also not even checking him, the first movement of Ferev. Like, he's always been highlighted as MVP's greatest support rotator, and he's done it perfectly.
That last fight too, like, they had a chance. It was a three-man corner. It was so good for Moon. And with the recently completed Axe of Tinker, they had the damage to actually kill people.
Just the double call.
Yeah, the double call.
The double call destroyed every chance they had.
And OG just limited to 5 kills. This game, still yet to kill QO.
They're gonna believe in their defense. They will stay in this game and not let it go. Of course, if there is even a slither of a chance that you can hold on to this series and maybe win the next fight, you gotta go with it. This is TI, this is winner's bracket.
It's nearly impossible at this point, though. Pipe completed on Shadow Demon. Invoker didn't go all in on an early game build. Just earned for the early game and then Midas. So he's transitioned quite well. Gold lead approaching 35,000.
Ferev's gonna go bot lane. Blade call, he finds Miracle. Ferev actually. The Blade Mail helped him find the damage to bring Tinker within range of Culling Blade. He had double march to the machines down. It was the oldest counter in the books to a Tinker. You just stand inside the march of the machines, like you Culling Blade down, a courier to boot. No Tinker for 40 seconds.
Yeah,
no buyback is available.
There's no way Sven's killing this PA.
Ferev again. He doesn't care. He just blinks in. He yule steps this up. No tail with a stifling dagger loses one third of his life. Then QO catches that crit. He takes out the big team fight controller and can just go from hero to hero. Ferev calls and brings No tail out of safety. They've got the stuns. They've got the control. They may not have the damage and they may not have the desire. Go back to the tier 3 towers. Make sure MVP get cleanly through into the semi final. Moonsville waiting in the tree line, hoping for an opportunity. All heroes are grouped up for a Chronosphere. Tinker's up in 2 seconds. Chrono on 2. No time blinks forward. Doesn't find a target. Now Tinker. Where is the damage from OG? QO jumps down. He finds Miracle with the control. He hasn't even used Abyssal Blade. Now he will. Holding Miracle there. Allowing the action to finish. And GG. Well played. MVP have trashed the 2-time major winners. The guys who are hoping to put a TI win under their belt, they may have to do it just like they did in Frankfurt. The journey through the lower bracket, they had a longer journey in that series, but at MVP, again, victors here on the TI stage.
I think MVP was probably one of the teams that benefited the most from the